Hello. This is a short video, well it won't be that short, but a video that will go through each of the possibilities for analyzing one and two variables, for exploring them. So essentially it's a review of the SPSS work from the STAT 1013 course. We start with a scenario in which we have one measurement variable, so water, weizhou.sav. And we just remind you that you have variable view, which gives us the name of the variable. It's the volume in the water bottle, and the data view, and so this is the number of milliliters in the bottle. And remember, the question was, is there really 500 milliliters in a bottle of 500 milliliter water? And so two things that you always do when you're analyzing individual variables is you look at them numerically and you look at them visually. First of all, we recognize this as a measurement variable, so we can see that here because we don't have classifications, either full, empty, or half empty, or something like that. These are actual measurements. We'll often see that in a description, so volume is typically something that's a measurement, so it would be a measurement variable. And you may have something in the label to give you some information about that. So it doesn't matter which tab we hit here. Now we go up to Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, and Frequencies to get the numerical descriptions. We put volume under variable, click off the frequencies, and then we want to click on mean, median, mode, standard deviation, minimum, maximum, and skewedness and kurtosis if we're interested in testing for normality. We may choose to use some of these as well, depending on our situation. Continue. And you can get graphs from up here, or we can produce a histogram, which is appropriate for one measurement variable, and we'll show the normal curve on the histogram, and so we'll get 2-for-1 special here. Now we look for the output, and it is, oh, it's underneath here, there it is. So we look at the output, and I'm just going to make that window a little smaller, and we see the mean is 525.2 milliliters, median 525 milliliters, mode, so they're all close together, which tells me that we're very close to normal distribution. Skewness is 0.428, kurtosis is negative 0.561, and so this tells me as well something about how normal the distribution is, as does the visual. So we look, explore things visually and numerically. But the key thing I want to point out in this clip is the SPSS. The analysis, the thinking about things once you produce the data will come. Next. So that was one measurement variable. Now one categorical variable. We're going to look at dice rolls. So this is 600 rolls of one die. So it should be die rolls. 600 rolls of one die, and each of these is a category. And we can check here. Remember clicking up here. You get either a 1, a 2, a 3, a 4, a 5, or a 6. Okay, so same thing. We want to see whether the die, when we roll this die, 600 times, so that's our N, whether the numbers came up equally as we would have expected. So let's take a look. This time we go to frequencies as well, but we leave this checked and we don't calculate the mean, median, mode. We can look at bar charts or pie charts. So I'm going to look at the pie chart. And we don't want to change it to percentages, because that'll put up the percentages, so we can take a look at that. And we want the variable amount, meaning the number that came up, number facing up. And we'll wait for the output to... And it'll be down here. Come on, where are you? And here it is. So we can see we had 200 ones, 52s, 53s, 54s, 55s, and 206s, all together with 600 rolls. So it looks like they didn't come up equally. Okay, the percentage values is 33, 8.3, and so on. And then the valid percent is, if we had missing values, it would remove them from the calculations, and cumulative percent, we build up towards the 100 percentile. All right. Now, next, we go to two measurement variables. We're going to look at medical terminology versus coding marks. So again, you're going to have some experience. You're going to use this data set in your analysis in this semester. And here we look at correlation. So the numerical exploration, we do correlate, bivariate. And we're going to look at the second midterm mark, medical terminology mark, with the coding mark. We'll see how much of a correlation there is. And I'm going to turn off my phone. All right, so we take a look at Pearson's R, and we have correlation of 0.705, which is a very high correlation. We'll take a look at a scatter plot. We go to legacy dialogues, scatter, simple scatter, define, some metric 2, and coding mark. And we click OK. And if you remember, when we see this, we look for how tightly packed and whether there's a trend, and we can put the line of best fit by double clicking on this. Click somewhere here, and we put in a line of best fit here. So that's our scatter plot. We can see that the correlation, the value of 0.705, when you square that, you would get 0.498. That's where the R squared comes from. And it tells us that we have fairly strong correlation, positive. Next, we look at two categorical variables, and you've seen this in the Stat 101.3 course. And what we see is we have two variables: immigrant status, yes or no, and whether the dwelling is owned by a member of one's household. And so here we look at, numerically, we look at a contingency table, which you can get through descriptive statistics and crosstabs. And remember, the independent variable goes in rows, the dependent variable goes in columns. And when we do that, we want the percentages in rows, because we're going to compare the percentages to calculate the relative risk, or the likelihood ratio. We click OK, which produces the table over here. And so we see 71% of immigrants, yes, live in a dwelling owned by a member of their household, and 74.8% no, do not live in a home. Okay, so, of non-immigrants live in a home owned by a member of their household. So we see that comparing non-immigrants to immigrants, the numbers are fairly close. And we can also take a look at, in this case, a paneled pie chart. So let's look at the paneled pie chart. And in this case, the issue will be immigrant status, will be the, we're going to panel by that. So because we're going to look at, within immigrant status, we're going to look at the rate of home ownership. But this sometimes will take you one or two tries to figure out whether you're on the right track. And we paneled by rows. So we see here the blue is dwelling owned by member of household. So that's about 71.4%. And this blue is 74.8%, which is very close to 3/4. So we have this nice blue 3/4 slice. Next, and finally, we have a comparison between comparison of means. So we have one categorical variable and one measurement variable. So we're going to look at born in Canada or not, similar to the previous one, and then number of siblings from Survey Stat 103 data set. So we go here, and we look at compare means. We're going to compare means. So were you born in Canada is the independent variable, because we're comparing those who were born in Canada to those who are not, and number siblings is a dependent variable. And we can look at some options here. We can put in mean, we can put in median, where is it? Oh, there it is. And we can move it up to the top here. Standard deviation can go beside median. Number of cases, just to take a look at that. And then it's always nice to look at minimums and maximums. I really like to look at minimum and maximum here, and you can get your range from that. Okay, so we've got that. We've taken a look at that. And now we've got 1.8. Those who were born in Canada have 1.8 siblings, and those who were not born in Canada have 2.26 siblings, so they have more siblings. And so we can do the same kind of thing when we have more than two groups to compare. Visually, we would look at box plots. That, I'm going to fly here. So this is the one we want. Were you born in Canada is the categorical variable. Number of siblings is the variable we're comparing them on. Click OK. And we have our comparison box plot. Yes, no, and we can see here that we have, well, here too, we can see that we've got a problem. So for some reason there's a one of the variables is coded incorrectly, or one of the cases. Anyway, that gives you a sense of which buttons to press and a review of the STAT 101.3, the SPSS, workings with SPSS.